gathered in their masses.
It's time for War Games.
Just like witches at Black Masses.
Assemble your team.
Generals gathered in their masses.
It's time for War Games.
Just like witches at Black Masses. Elijah!
Be the last one standing. Beat the game. Win the war. NXT TakeOver War Games. Sign up now at WWENetwork.com. Assemble your team.
Generals gathered in their masses.
It's time for War Games.
Just like witches at Black Masses.
Now, WWE Network presents NXT TakeOver War Games pre-show.
From the one and only Capital Wrestling Center, as the NXT Universe makes their way in tonight, four sinister sides of steel threaten to forever change the careers of 16 NXT superstars. It's NXT TakeOver War Games. Welcome to the TakeOver War Games pre-show. I'm Sam Roberts. You might know me from SiriusXM or right here on the WWE Network. But tonight, I'm joined by a five-time Intercontinental Champion, the voice of NXT, out of the commentary booth and by my side. And I think it's great news, ladies and gentlemen. Wade Barrett.
Thank you very much, Sam, and what a thrill it is for me to be here tonight at my first ever TakeOver War Games. There is a terror humming in the air of this building as the ominous War Games structure hangs above the ring here at the Capitol Wrestling Center.
I mean, Wade, you've done so much in your career as a WWE superstar, but never anything like this. What do you think the superstars that are participating in tonight's War Games matches are thinking right now?
Look, here's the deal. I've been in steel cage matches. I've been in elimination chambers. I know about the pain of these structures. I've never been inside one of those and had a team of opponents all coming at me at the same time. There is only one word to describe what they're feeling, and that is terror.
Well, I can tell you this, the WWE Universe is not feeling terror. There's a feeling in this building that something special is gonna happen tonight, the last NXT TakeOver of 2020. The question is, who's gonna deliver that something special? Will it be these four men, the Undisputed Era, who have built their legacy inside the War Games cage? Or will it be their opponents who they've gotta go four on four with tonight? Of course, the egotistical Pat McAfee, Oney Lorcan, Danny Burch, and Pete Dunne. I guess he's got his own shirt.
Undisputed Era against Pat McAfee's crew, a match that can be summed up with one word: hatred. War Games was designed for rivalries like this one. Expect destruction and a lot of pain.
And there are title ramifications tonight. The North American title, to be exact, as the champion that nobody saw coming, the ultimate underdog, Leon Ruff, defends that North American championship against two former champions, Damian Priest and Johnny TakeOver himself, Johnny Gargano.
Next up, Dexter Lumis against Cameron Grimes. These are two men who cannot stand the sight of each other. Well, they're gonna be strapped together until they settle this one once and for all. In a strap match, there is nowhere to run, nowhere to hide.
Things are going to get ugly, Wade. Get ready for a fight, because tonight, Tommaso Ciampa goes one-on-one against the master of Thatch's Thatch Can, Timothy Thatcher.
And finally, Team Shotzi versus Team Candice. The level of competition in the women's division is so intense that each of these eight ladies will need to bring an A-plus performance tonight. This one might steal the show.
An absurdly loaded card, no doubt. And wait, news is still breaking. They don't tell me because they're afraid that I spoil things, but they do tell Mackenzie Mitchell, and luckily, she's backstage with us tonight.
Thanks, guys. There's definitely a heightened sense of anticipation coming out of both locker rooms. Earlier today, I did see both teams arrive, Team Pat McAfee as well as Undisputed Era, and I did get the chance to talk to Pat McAfee. He seems very confident that his team will walk away with a win tonight. On the other hand, Undisputed Era, they didn't really have too much to say collectively, but I did see them ringside, and it looked like they were surveying the double rings, the double cages, maybe putting a strategy together of what they'll do tonight. But I briefly spoke to Adam Cole as well, and he said, listen, Pat McAfee's a great talker, but the time for talking is over. Tonight, we go to war. Now, moving on to the women's division. I did get the chance to just speak to Mr. Regal and now can confirm that tonight, the women's War Games match will kick off the show. Now, knowing that, let's take a look at how the teams came to be.
Wait a minute, there's that masked superstar.
We're gonna have a new women's champ here.
There's Shotzi Blackheart running in a fierce. No. Io Shirai retains her women's title.
Candice LeRae has been completely obliterated.
Shotzi, hey, Shotzi.
You get in my way, I run you over.
Candice didn't just destroy my tank. She destroyed a piece of me.
You want to send me a message, Candice? Well, here's one right back.
We are going to war!
Let me introduce you to my War Games team. Raquel Gonzalez, Dakota Kai, and...
What the?
Oh!
Toni Storm. Unpredictability, resilience, strength. I have everything I need to win at War Games.
Well, that's NXT Women Champion Io Shirai.
Candice LeRae's War Games team. Ripley trying to take them all by herself, but the numbers advantage, too great.
You gotta wonder if you're Shotzi Blackheart, what is going through your mind at this moment?
People like to tear you down. They want to destroy everything. But in life, you rebuild and you rise up.
Hey, Shotzi.
It's our destiny.
War Games? I'm in. Every type needs his weapon. Your team? Missing some heavy artillery.
Not anymore.
There's Rhea Ripley! There's Ember Moon!
Let's go to war.
There's two people, and they're damaged goods.
Team LeRae taking out Team Blackheart. Wait a minute, Io Shirai. We have found out who the fourth member is. Team Blackheart has the War Game advantage. Team LeRae, you're looking at your future. Shotzi Blackheart, Rhea Ripley, Ember Moon, and the NXT Women's Champion, Io Shirai, are going to war.
This is the Credit One Bank One to watch. Visit GoCreditOne.com. Life ever rewarded.
And this week's Credit One Bank One to watch is the Women's War Games match. And I'll tell you why, Wade Barrett, because I've been saying for months on my podcast that the women's division in NXT is the best women's division in wrestling today, bar none. I mean, look at Team Shotzi on its own. First of all, you got Shotzi Blackheart, who has risen to superstardom in the last 8 weeks or so at a level that I have not seen in a very long time. You've got Rhea Ripley, who was declared the future of the industry by Triple H himself. You've got Ember Moon, whose title reign in NXT is the stuff of legends. And oh yeah, you got this sleeper, Io Shirai, who's got a title around her waist that accurately describes her as the best women's wrestler in the world. Wade, I think this may be the best collection of talent in a single match that we've seen in years.
You know what? I'd actually agree with everything you said there for once, but I'd even take it a step further. It's not just the best women's division on the planet. It is the best division on the planet, male or female. These ladies, week in, week out, over-deliver, and I'm expecting big things from them tonight.
Yeah, you might be right. Let's talk about Rhea Ripley and the fact that last year at War Games, she made a name for herself in this very match. Is there somebody in this match that you think has the ability to look past the peril and clutch the potential of War Games?
Yeah, of course, Rhea Ripley is in the match again this year, and she could steal the show herself. However, if I have to name somebody else, I'm going to have to go with Raquel Gonzalez. She has been on a streak lately. She's been incredible, getting better week by week. So big, so strong, so malicious. Somehow, some way, Team Shotzi have to find a way to neutralize that threat.
This has been the Credit One Bank One to Watch. Visit GoCreditOne.com. Life ever rewarded.
And Wade, you might as well call this one the Battle of the Tough Guys. Tommaso Ciampa one-on-one with Timothy Thatcher tonight at NXT TakeOver War Games. I think it surprised a lot of people, probably Tommaso Ciampa specifically. When last week on NXT, Tommaso Ciampa goes into the ring, he confronts Timothy Thatcher. And what does Timothy Thatcher do? Not only does he take him down, but he leaves Tommaso Ciampa laying. Timothy Thatcher rendered Tommaso Ciampa unconscious. The last time we saw Tommaso Ciampa on a takedown, he was rendered unconscious. It seems to me that Tommaso Ciampa has entered a stage in his career where he can't stay awake in the ring. Wade, what does that do to a competitor's confidence?
Well, I'd be very careful what you're saying about Tommaso Ciampa. He is a nasty, nasty man. And believe me, he is a prideful man too. He was embarrassed by Timothy Thatcher last week. I saw Tommaso Ciampa arriving at the arena today. Earphones on, almost in a trance-like state. Nobody could communicate with him. Everybody was keeping out of his way. He has some really bad intentions, and that could spell some bad news for Timothy Thatcher tonight.
Well, it just may if he can tap into the Ciampa of old, but we have so much to do on tonight's pre-show. We're going to check in with Matt Camp and Ryan Popola from WWE's The Bump, and of course, help us break down the men's war game match. Ariel Helwani from ESPN. Stay right there.
War games! War games! War games!
We're ready for Cameron Grimes!
War games!
War games!
War games!
War games!
War games! In the fields of battle. War games!
War games!
War games!
All of you, absolutely appalling.
War games!
It's gonna be war games!
Did you say war?
War
That's
games!
Not, it's not war.
War!
It's war!
War!
War, no!
War!
That's not.
War! Is what is it good for?
Are you just gonna
That's how
it's
you say
not
it.
War, it's war.
War,
no,
yeah,
okay.
You said it.
You're just,
war.
I can't.
War game! War. It's war, like, right?
No.
War games!
War games!
It's not fair with your accent. Well, I'll tell you, that was fun, but a couple that I hope does not think tonight is going to be fun are the Garganos. They're going to be super busy tonight as Johnny is in this match alongside Damian Priest, who's looking very confident as he enters the Capitol Wrestling Center. Tonight, of course, that man, Leo Ruff, with stars in his eyes, defends the North American Championship against two of the greatest threats that any competitor in NXT could ever have.
Oh my God!
Johnny Gargano becomes the first ever two-time North American champion.
Welcome to Johnny Gargano's Wheel of Challenger! Leo
is a rank outsider. It could have been Ciampa, it could have been Priest. He's in over his head at this point.
That's Damian Priest.
And the man Gargano beat for the title.
Gargano's made a deal with the devil. Talk about being thrown off your game. Oh, crucifix pin, shoulders out. Oh, oh my God. Leon Ruff has shocked the world as the new NXT North American Champion.
I walked through the back and I saw everybody standing there clapping, just giving me, you know, their respect. It felt like something that I've been chasing for a while finally coming true.
This whole experience has been crazy in itself. It's been a dream come true while also feeling like I'm still
dreaming.
Turn
it off! Turn it off! Everybody knows last week was a fluke. You're not a real champion. You're a joke. And tonight, the joke's over. That title is coming home to me.
This match is official. North American Championship on the line. Gargano wasting no time, taking a right to Leon Ruff. Into the cover for the championship.
Sorry, kid. Priest has screwed Gargano once again.
Everybody thinks that I'm a joke. So here's the punchline.
Ruff taking it to both Gargano and Priest.
I'll face the both of them.
Please welcome the North American champion, Leon Ruff.
Be proud of what you did.
I did become the NXT North American champion. Yes, I did. Because I beat Johnny Gargano once and twice. Yeah!
No, no, no. You're just a pawn in Damian Priest's stupid game to make me look like a fool.
Surprise, surprise. Johnny Wheel of Fortune out here crying, complaining about losing. He beat you twice.
Because of you. And as a matter of fact, you face me one-on-one for that title, Leon, I'm gonna become the North American champion, just like I should have been the whole time.
Wasn't it you in your tough guy moment last week that said you would defend that against the both of us?
A takeover War Games. It will be Leon Ruff versus Johnny Gargano versus Damian Priest for the North American Championship in a triple threat match.
Wade, the NXT Universe still doesn't know quite what to make of Leon Ruff's unexpected title reign. What is his path to victory in tonight's triple threat?
I don't believe there is one. Here's the deal. Leon Ruff is the North American champion for two reasons. Number one, he's very, very lucky. Number two, Damian Priest has helped him every step of the way. Neither of those things is going to happen tonight. One way or another, he's losing that championship.
You've been saying that every single week on NXT TV.
I'll be right.
Well, you've been wrong every single week, and there are two competitors not taking him seriously. I would say that works in Leon Ruff's favor, but it doesn't really matter what we think because our boss, Triple H, has thoughts on it.
They are used to that big dance. They are used to that big game. They're used to that moment. Mm-hmm. This is his first shot. How bad does that affect him? How panicked is he? How emotional is he? Because if he goes in there and he can't breathe because he can't control his emotions and he can't catch his air and he's got two guys to go against and he thinks he's got to beat both of them, he's doomed.
Let's go ahead and answer the question that everybody in America wants to know. What are the thoughts of Ryan Popola and Matt Camp from WWE's The Bump?
Thanks, guys. Ryan and I are very excited for NXT TakeOver War Games tonight. Let's jump right into it with the strap match. It's Dexter Lumis, it's Cameron Grimes, and Ryan, nobody can get away.
Nobody can get away. Cameron Grimes can't get to the moon when you're strapped to Dexter Lumis. I don't see a path to victory for Cameron Grimes. Give me Dexter.
I know Grimes been worried about this, but when the bell rings, he's a heck of a competitor.
No doubt.
He's a scrappy guy in there. However, I'm with you. It's Dexter Lumis' night. Now, who will it be when it's Timothy Thatcher and Tommaso Ciampa? They don't need straps or chairs. They got fists. They got kicks. They got a brain that can get it done in the ring. Who do you got, Ryan?
Timothy Thatcher's a bad man. I want to make that crystal clear. However, the song doesn't sing Timothy Thatcher will survive. It sings no one will survive Eileen Tommaso.
We saw what Thatcher did to Tommaso this past week. I think he does it again tonight. Now, a man who's on cloud nine is Leon Ruff. He's the North American champion, but he's got the biggest test of his life tonight. He faces two former North American champions in Johnny Gargano and Damian Priest. Does he stay on cloud nine?
As crazy as this sounds, Maddie, any other time of the year, I would take Johnny or Damian. But it's a season of miracles. He's already accomplished one. I don't know how, but give me Leon Ruff to retain. I'm just saying it.
I worry about those ghost faces. I don't care what time of year it is. I think Johnny Gargano becomes a three-time North American champion. Two War Games matches. We start with the women. Team Candace versus Team Shotzi. Only in NXT with this women's division can you have this type of War Games matchup.
Agree with that 100%. Both teams are stacked. I think both teams are even. And when it's this close, my tiebreaker, give me the team that has Io Shirai.
I think the X factor is Raquel Gonzalez, which is why I am picking Team Candace. And finally, the other War Games match, Undisputed Era against Team McAfee. Very, very personal.
Very personal. And Maddie, I said this to you on Wednesday on the bump. I think that's the key for Undisputed Era. They're going to want to focus on Pat McAfee. They're going to have him literally caged in. I think they need to stay level. I think they need to stay measured. They'll get it done. But if they focus too much on Pat, I think that's when it gets tricky.
Team McAfee's got the money, the power, and Pete Dunne has won this before, and he's better than ever. I'm taking Team McAfee. We're excited for it all. Back to you guys.
Well, tonight's the night. There's going to be no escape for Cameron Grimes as the next chapter in the Dexter Lumis-Cameron Grimes rivalry is illustrated. Tonight, it's a strap match.
Cameron Grimes, always at the right place at the right time.
Oh, cave-in, cover by Cameron Grimes. Good night.
And I'm taking it to the moon.
Oh, Dexter Lumis.
Where on earth did Lumis slither in from?
The NXT Universe wants to see you face Dexter Lumis one more time in a strap match, a takeover.
I don't think you quite understand what happens strapped up to Cameron Grimes.
Grimes looks like he's seen a ghost. Cameron Grimes will have nowhere to run against Dexter Lumis in the leather strap match at Takeover War Games.
Cameron Grimes, what are your thoughts on your strap match tonight against Dexter Lumis? Cameron, what are you looking at?
What I want to know, McKenzie, who made that video? Let me be the first one to tell you, McKenzie, that video, whatever that was that just played right there, that was not accurate. Cameron Grimes ain't scared of anybody. Cameron Grimes, I ain't ever ran from anybody either, McKenzie. Tell you the truth, Dexter Lumis, you're the one that's scared. You ain't said nothing, and I've said everything I could ever say. But after tonight, Lumis, when you're strapped up to me, the man, Cameron Grimes, when you're strapped up to me, you're gonna be screaming. You know what he's gonna be screaming, McKenzie? Tell him what he's gonna be screaming. He's going to be screaming that I'm going to the moon! Yeah!
And here we go with our main event.
Excuse me, Mr. Broken Jaw, but while you were sitting at home nursing that jaw with your wife, you had to have seen what we've been doing.
It's easy for the mice to play when the cat's away, but the cat
is back. And look what I just dragged in.
You gotta be kidding me! The CWC is exploding before
our eyes! Eight fighters, two teams of four. I think, gentlemen, you know how this goes. War Games!
Fields of bodies burning as the war machine keeps turning. Death and hatred to mankind, poisoning their brainwashed minds. Oh, Lord, yeah.
It's no secret this team was put together by money. A lot of money. And just like every good team, you have to invest in greatness, and that's what I did in these three men joining me for this run. We are men of class. We are professional. We are the new kings of NXT. We are the group of men that have been running this show from top to bottom.
Your money will not help you. You are trapped inside a giant cage and two rings with four of the baddest men that NXT has ever seen. And when you've got four guys as pissed off as we are, I can promise you, it will end you. You're in the match that the Undisputed Era made famous in NXT.
We're gonna prove who the hell we are!
Drag the four of you through absolute hell!
Well, I hate to break it to you. I have three badasses with me that run this business. So on Sunday, two rings, two cages, two teams, one brutal truth.
This Sunday, we end the Undisputed Era.
Wade, this is a special night, and it requires a special guest here with us to help break down the men's War Game match is ESPN correspondent Ariel Helwani. What's going on, Ariel?
Guys, what a huge honor this is for me, a massive honor. I'm here with the bare-knuckle boxing legend, the NXT legend, Wade Barrett. And Sam, it's good to see you again as well.
Well, Ariel, I know you've also been disrespectful to Booker T publicly, but I also know that you are a huge wrestling fan. I know that you grew up with wrestling. Did you grow up watching the War Games? And what do you feel about NXT's reinvention of the Match Beyond?
Okay, well, first of all, yes, I did grow up watching and loving pro wrestling. Sam, to be honest with you, I have forgotten more about this business in the past 15 minutes than you probably have learned over the past 10 years
or
so.
He's got a good point.
No, he doesn't. No, he really doesn't.
You talk about War Games, you talk about WCW, I can close my eyes. I'm in Greensboro Coliseum. It's 1987. It's the Four Horsemen. It's Dusty Rhodes. What do you know about that, Sam? You know nothing about that. And when they brought it back 3 years ago, it was very exciting to me, and it was a new twist on this great match without the roof, so you could get some amazing finishes like we saw last year. Adam Cole going through the table. It's such a great part of this business. I was so excited when it came back, and I love everything about NXT because it gave young wrestlers like Wade Barrett and so many others. I remember when NXT was just a little segment on a TV show. Now look at it. World-renowned, one of the best brands in pro wrestling. To me, they asked me if I wanted to appear on Survivor Series. They said, pick whichever show you want to appear on, any pre-show, Survivor Series, Royal Rumble, any. I said, I want War Games because to me, this is the biggest night of the year in professional wrestling.
So the last time somebody came on a pre-show and was as much of a smart aleck, they ended up in the War Games match itself tonight. I'm talking about Pat McAfee alongside Oney Lorcan, Danny Burch, Pete Dunne. They're going to be going 4-on-4 against the Undisputed Era. Who do you have in that match, Ariel Helwani?
Well, to be honest, this feels like a big fight. It has that big fight feel. I know about big fights. I cover big fights for a living. I'm a professional journalist. I'm one of the most ethical and unbiased journalists in combat sports, so I know a thing or two about this stuff. I'm wondering if Pat McAfee's actually going to show up tonight after the verbal beatdown that I gave him on his Rinky Dink show on Friday and Booker T as well, but we won't talk about him. I love everything about this because, to me, this is almost like the 2004 NBA Finals. the Team McAfee squad are like the Lakers. They were bound together by greed, by money. They were chasing rings, chasing gold, right? These guys aren't a cohesive unit. They're not a family. They're not in it for each other. They're in it for themselves. Meanwhile, you have Undisputed Era, the faces of NXT, the ones who essentially brought this match back, 1-2 in War Games matches, by the way. They don't have gold these days, and there's some cracks in the armor, and there are people who are wondering if they still have what it takes to be the faces of NXT. People are counting these guys out. People are starting to say, you know what, their best days are behind them. I think they're going to come up big. I think they're going to remind everyone who the faces of NXT are. Like Roy Jones Jr. once said back in 2003, y'all must have forgot. Undisputed Era is going to remind everyone that they are the kings of NXT tonight.
Ariel Helwani, thank you. That contraption of carnage is lowering right now. The NXT War Games have begun. Takeover is coming up next on the WWE Network.
After weeks of mind games, let me in. Has Randy Orton finally found the Fiend's?
Assemble your team.
Generals gathered in their masses.
It's time for War Games.
Just like witches at Black Masses.
Assemble your team.
Generals gathered in their masses.
It's time for War Games.
Just like witches at Black Masses.
Be the last one standing. Beat the game. Win the war. NXT Takeover War Games.